Everyone, welcome to a brand new vlog where Abby is taking the freaking sports car through some country lanes. I genuinely thought I had my shit together when I was on the way to Glastonbury. And then I just, like, you know when you panic and you're like, oh shit, I'm actually going the right way. I've actually not done this for quite a long time. So I put the sat nav on, and now the sat nav has taken me through country lanes, and I think I figured out where I am, and I might as well just have gone a different way. But anyways, it is Sunday fun day. I overslept, so everything is running late, but it's fine because my friend Lydia is just the same as me. And I'm ready. I've washed my hair, I've had a good sleep, the sun is shining, life is good. And we're having a few little catch-up girly hours in Glastonbury. So Lydia's one of my friends who... Actually, she's probably one of my oldest friends now. We actually used to work together. This was back when I worked in a cafe in Clifton. So when I first started my business... So basically, little story time. I get asked this a lot, like how I started it. So when I left school, I did my A-levels, and I got my A-levels, but I didn't want to go to uni. So I decided to just work. And so I worked in a cafe, and it was through the cafe that I met someone who became my first ever client. I got to go right in a second. This is very pretty, despite the fact that I didn't want to go this way. It's very pretty. So yes, I worked in a cafe, and basically as I started to get more clients and earn more money through my business, I reduced my hours in the cafe. So that's how I started. I think I get asked that a lot. Also, bearing in mind as well, because I was so young, I lived at home, so I didn't have to replace my income in a way that I would have done if I were in like the position that I'm in right now. So that was one of the huge benefits actually of starting a business so young, that I didn't have to worry about rent or bills or food or pretty much anything. So yes, Lydia is my friend who I worked in the cafe with. So that's getting on for, God, that's got to be like 6 years ago. I started there when I was 17, and I think when I left, I was 19. So yeah, 7 years ago. Yeah, I just love her so much. She's just got such a beautiful, high vibe personality. She doesn't take life too seriously, but she also gets shit done. And she actually got married last year as well. So I don't know if I was vlogging at that point. I think I might have been actually. So it was her wedding that I went to. So yeah, but obviously being adults and the way that we are, we don't get to see each other very much because she lives over in Bath. So yes, I am very excited for today because she's an incredible florist. So she works as a florist, but she's also got an illustration business, which she does online. And she is one of the most talented artists I've ever known. Obviously, I would say that because she's my friend, but genuinely, she is so freaking talented, it's unbelievable. So I am gonna tag her illustration details below, because she does, what's the word? When she does like, oh God. I've actually, like, my brain stopped working. Like, you ask her for something and she'll do it for you. There's a word for it. You know what I mean, I'll get her to say it. Yeah, I want to go and see a fortune teller, and I need to buy some sage so I can get rid of all the shitty boy energy in the flat. And Lucy wants some as well. Oh my God, there's a dog trying to get out. What else? Have some food. In fact, she did just voice note me saying, can we get food? Yes, we can. Vlog fail. Oh, forgot to take the camera with me. Left it in the car where I was filming. And that was the end of that. I'm back here. Ugg boots, what am I doing? Oh my God. I have got home about an hour ago from Glastonbury, and I'm going out for a walk because it's been intense. So basically, I met Lydia, we had a lush time, we had some nice food, we went in all the little shops, we went in a little goddess temple and did some meditating. I love a bit of Glastonbury, I'm into this stuff. But I basically had a tarot reading, and I've never had one before in person. And it was meant to be like 40 minutes, and I landed up being in there an hour. I didn't even know I was in there that long, because obviously I wasn't looking at the clock or my phone or anything. Oh my god, I'm not gonna say too much about it because I feel like it was a very, very private and personal hour, and I wasn't expecting, to be honest, what I was expecting was to go in there, be told like, oh, XYZ's gonna happen, think, oh, that's great, right, let's go on. And that was kind of that. What actually happened was I felt like I had a therapy session, an intense reading session, an intense look at what's actually going on in my life right now and what do I need to address session, everything. And I'm a bit freaked out as well. Like, I really, really am on this wavelength, and to me it doesn't seem odd that this person who had never met me before just knew everything, and I mean everything. Every single thing that came up was right, and it brought up some big, big questions for myself, and just, I guess, highlighted shit that I need to sort out. I mean, she did say to me, she went, this is actually a really good reading. Like, there's only, compared to like most people, there's not much that you need to physically do. But for me, being like a bit of a control freak perfectionist, I still looked at those and obviously dwelled on those. Yeah, I mean, there were some really good things that she said are coming and that I can expect, but only if I address basically the stuff I need to address, like, for example, loving myself more, letting things go, having more fun. That was quite an interesting one. I thought I had fun, but now that I really think about it, I'm like, no, I don't have loads of fun. Just being a bit more carefree, like a bit more like let my child spirit come out a bit more. What else did she say? Get in nature a bit more, get my like balance right, which is a big one, like basically not work as much, and just slow down. So things that I feel like I already knew, but when you get told these things in that sort of way in quite an intense period of time, and obviously with the energy of like Glastonbury, I sort of drove home. I don't really remember driving home, and I've come home and I just looked at my work phone and just my brain just went, ugh. Shit. I just feel so like energetically exhausted and burnt out anyway, so I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna go for a really long walk outside and get some fresh air, and then come back, do the bare minimum of shit that I've got to get done for tomorrow, and then I'm just gonna tidy up and try and get a really early night, because I'm not gonna lie, that was so much more intense than I thought it was gonna be. And yeah, I was not mentally prepared for that, I'm not gonna lie. The only good thing is I didn't get told that I was gonna die, which was like a worry of mine. I was like, oh my god, imagine if I go in and she's gonna tell me I'm gonna die. Monday. I had one of those mornings where I just couldn't get up and I just could not do life. Probably because I went to bed at 1:30 in the morning as well. Need to stop doing this. And you know, just one of those mornings where like I spilt stuff, the cat was going on at me, I couldn't get something open, one of them. And I was feeling really stressed and apprehensive, which was so not how I wanted to start today, just because I've got like a hospital appointment and then I've got a meeting and then I'm also meant to be recording a podcast this afternoon. So I just wanted to start on a good note, but it just wasn't happening. And then I stopped to get a coffee to bring with me, so I've had something, and I just went in somewhere that I go all the time, and she just went, oh no, that's fine, like, you have that. And honestly, like, I know it's only a coffee and I know it's only something really small, but small gestures like that always just remind me that there is good in the world. And when you're having, particularly when you're having a bit of a shit time, a bit of a shit day, you just have to refocus and you have to be like, no, like, life is good. It was just like a tiny little pivotal moment, and now I'm like, oh, like, honestly, it nearly made me cry. When someone does very small acts of kindness, it honestly actually really does, like, almost make me cry. And it's just because I appreciate it so much, and I see, like, I'm just so full of gratitude all the time, that it is a big deal for me. Thank you to lovely Helga who gave me a coffee. I'm actually early. I am never early, but I'm early. I'm sat in the hospital car park and I'm just like, right, breathe, everything's gonna be fine. I feel like I'm going in there and I don't know what I'm gonna be coming out like, and it's stressing me out a little bit, but I need to calm down because I can't control the outcome, and it is what it is. And I still feel a bit like weirded out from yesterday's tarot reading. And I'm trying like not to think about it, but I'm a bit weirded out. Yes. Wow, I have a lot to update you on the vlog. Since I was sat in my car this morning outside the hospital, it has just been non-stop. So just an overview, we've had major high. I'm not gonna go too much into the appointment right now. I'm gonna actually do a proper clip on it later when I'm like not stressed out working. All I'm saying is a miracle has happened and I'm all good. For the first time in what feels like 10 years, and quite literally is 10 years, I'm all good. And I'm not gonna go into it right now because I'm gonna cry, but it's happy tears, and and just some very cool stuff with work that's happened today and come up, and I just know everything is good. And it was all good until I was on the phone pacing up and down the office to get my steps in and somebody drove into my car. They've driven into my TT and damaged 3 panels. Basically, we've got a family friend who owns a car body repair shop up the road. So as it happened, like 20 minutes later, I phoned him and was like, please, can you look at my car? I just whizzed it up there, and yeah, it's properly damaged. 3 panels. Apparently it's not too big a job. It's like, what's the word? Even though it is 3 sort of areas, it's like 3 basic areas. It's the light and 2 the bumper and the side panel. So basically when I was opening the door, it was like crunching. So he's managed to stop it doing that a little bit for me. So I'm all good for a week or two until I get it fixed. But it's just annoying. Like, I was on such a high. And then I saw that and was like, oh, really? Really? But it is what it is. Perspective. Nobody died. It's not a write-off. It can be fixed. It's all good. So, yes. Now I'm eating what looks like a mega yum salad from Co-op. Co-op lunchtime food is banging. What did I get? I'll show you. I got
That sauce, what is that?
Mezze salad. So I think it's got couscous, beetroot, hummus, salad. Is that a cashew dressing? Oh, it's so good. Cauliflower. What else is in here? Olive fritters with sweet potato and red onion, charcoal red peppers and tahini dressing. And I've also put some chicken for extra protein and coleslaw. Way to my heart. No joke, is Co-op deli coleslaw. Oh my god. I absolutely freaking love it. So yummy. But I've had, yeah, I also had, before that happened, I had a call with a brand new client, which is fun. Fun. And in 45 minutes time, I've got my podcast. So I need to not dwell on my car and get in the zone for that. Eat this, get in the podcast zone and get the inspirational juices flowing. Even though I've forgotten what she's actually asking me, so I should probably have a look at that. Podcast ready. Right. Zoom in. Obviously, if you could see the mess, you guys can see on the vlog because you're allowed to see the behind the scenes, the mess in here. But you can't see it on the screen, so that's all that matters. Right, I'm actually going to keep you guys on for a bit. You might switch off, but there might be a few little snippets that I think, oh yeah, that would be really good in the vlog. So I'm gonna keep you on whilst I do this and let's see how it goes. Obviously you're
hi everyone.
Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry.
That's fine, Abby. A massive welcome. Please share with everyone what you do in a little nutshell and how you got there.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. So, my name is Abigail Hunter, and I own a company called Abigail Hunter Marketing. Very original, I know. So, I own a social media and digital marketing agency. So, I work with independent businesses, primarily in the Southwest, but now across the UK, to basically help them level up their social media. Yeah, of course. So I had this like burning desire when I was in my teen years to have my own platform. So I started a blog where I used to blog about fashion and lifestyle and recipes and just everything and anything that I fancied really. And when I was about 15, 16, I actually started to do brand collabs with companies who approached me to either gift me or eventually actually pay me to advertise for them. Yeah, basically self-taught. Well, not basically, completely self-taught. And just sort of learned as I went, really, that I had to learn. So, and I was like trying to figure out who I was as well. So trying to figure out like my identity and that of a business was, looking back, I'm like, oh my goodness, like how did I do that? But I think, yeah, I was just open. I was open to anything, willing to try anything. I think I've always been very good at staying in my own lane and doing my own thing and not getting distracted by the noise of everybody else. It's just something that I've never really cared about. I've just naturally always done my own thing. I guess after doing a lot of, you know, self-inner work, have really started to accept that and to actually be grateful for the fact that I get to work with people who choose to work with me, but also I am very much in alignment with their brands.
The rest of your week.
Thank you.
Thanks everyone.
One more thing done. One more thing done. Okay, I'm just in my basement. I just got back from the gym, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not having a good few hours. You can tell from my face. I'm just knackered. I'm gonna be on album training. I just can't do it. And I never get like this, but I just feel like I'm gonna burst into tears. Like, I just can't do life right now. And I need what is left of the night. I think it's like 9 o'clock. I need it off. Let me show you the car. It's actually so much worse than I thought it was. They've obviously gone, scraped like this way, and the whole alloy, it was already bad, but it's now like completely ruined. This whole panel here, every time I open the door, it like creaks. So yeah, this whole panel here needs replacing. the whole bumper apparently here needs replacing, and the light, obviously you can see it's like popped out, that needs replacing. So yeah. Oh, should I get my number plate in that? Not ideal at all. It's like £1,900 to fix. Obviously it's not my problem. They're gonna have to pay for it. Well, their insurance is gonna have to pay for it. But you know when it's just like another thing to sort out? I'm also gonna be really nosy because I saw a bus stopped outside my building and there's a police car by it. And I'm just a nosy cow. It's just like another thing to have to sort out. And it's annoying. Oh, are they still there? Oh, yeah. Someone doesn't want to get off the bus. Oh dear. So, yes. We all have those days, guys, but it's just so annoying because honestly, I had an absolutely sensational morning. Like, I couldn't have asked for a better morning. And I'll tell you why a bit later. Well, I'll tell you why tomorrow. I can't be asked to do anything else today. And then that happened, and it's just like, yep, that lady yesterday was right. I need to slow it. I need to slow it down. I can't keep going at this pace because I'm actually worried I might have a heart attack. Even though my heart's healthy. Woo. Yeah, it's too much. It's just too much. So between my meetings, Granny has come to have a health cheers Prosecco.
Yeah.
What did you just say about men? What do they do?
Cheat.
Cheat. Yeah, yeah. What but them. you just did, you said something else.
They swipe.
Yes.
I've seen it on television.
Clearly getting lots of work done. We're planning the birthday. Granny's gonna do a granny spread for the girls.
All of this food, because otherwise you might feel really ill. You have to eat first.
You all have to eat first. We've got a bottle of Prosecco each on the bus.
Oh, Abby, you're gonna feel so ill.
I know.
Well, where are you going off to sleep? Where are you gonna sleep?
At home.
You're coming home, but not in the bus.
Loads of us are coming home, yeah.
To your flat. Mm. As long as you're not on your own.
No.
Oh, that's good.
I will be safe.
Mm.
Yeah. Never have I been
no.
drinking.
No. You need to be together.
No boys.
No boys. No boys allowed.
No boys. There's no room.
Remembers that song from Angus Thongs and Perfect Snogging. That is like such throwback. What's going on? My hair is falling out as we speak, but I kind of don't really care. I'm at the Mall and I'm not dressed for the Mall, I'm dressed for work. I had to get a hot chocolate. My chocolate craving at the moment is mental. I think it must be hormone related because I only get it a couple of days of the month, but when I do get it, Jesus, I can eat a lot of chocolate. And it's not sweets, it's not like cake, like it's just chocolate, like hot chocolate or just like chocolate but like bars. Does anyone else get that? So I think I took a little clip of basically between my meetings, my gran decided to pop in and have a coffee with me. And then Ramona, who my friend, but was my second meeting because I work with her, got there early. So we ended up having like a little mother's meeting where basically they ganged up on me and were like trying to talk to me about dating and stuff. And in their words, if you want something, just ask. Like, get over being asked. But I can't get over being asked. Like, I just can't. So they were trying to, yeah. Do that, and then we're talking about It's so funny having these conversations with like my grandma, because she, I talk to my gran about pretty much everything, but she just does not understand 21st century dating. Like, she doesn't understand, and it's not her fault at all, but it is a little bit like, you can tell she can't quite process the fact that I'm happy not with a man or in a relationship. She like just doesn't seem to get that. And she doesn't understand how dating works. Like, for her, it's like you go on one date with someone and it's like, oh, you're gonna marry that person, whereas I'm trying to be like, well, not even, I don't even date really, but I don't know. Does anyone else have this? Like, where just the older generation just don't understand how dating works nowadays. And don't get me wrong, I think there's like good and bad to both. Like, obviously she met my granddad way younger than me and had like married two kids by the time she was my age, and that was normal, whereas I'm like having my fun. And I think there's like good and bad to both, but yeah, it's just funny. It's just funny having this conversation. Oh, speak of the devil and she shall appear. Right, bye.
Hello, sweetheart, where are you?
So basically, I'm in the car waiting for my friend. So I thought, whilst I have 5 minutes, I would do my little roundup of what happened yesterday. So obviously before my car got beaten up. So my heart appointment, I went and I had an ECG and an echo. If you don't know what that is, an ECG is when they, oh God, I don't even know, they wire you up and they see like your heart rhythm. That's the thing that goes like that on a piece of paper, when you might have seen that. And an echo is where they basically do an ultrasound of your heart. So a bit like when you're pregnant and they want to see the baby. I've not had an echo for ages, actually. Oh, there she is. That's not gone well, has it? Basically, all in all, I'm not going to go into it massively, but there was a 50-50 chance after my surgery that one side of my heart that was enlarged would go down. It doesn't always, but sometimes it does. So I was kind of hoping it would. It's taken 5 years, but it has gone down. When I went last year for a checkup, it hadn't. So in the last year, the enlarged side of my heart has shrunk, which feels like a bloody miracle. I literally texted Abby and I was like, I'm like the baby Jesus, miracles happened. Yeah, so what that basically means is that I now have as healthy a heart as anybody my age, and I don't need to stress, I don't need to worry, I need to stay fit and healthy as everybody does, maybe a little bit more so, but I also don't have any worries with having kids, so I can stop being stressed about that and live life on my own timeline and not that of my heart and my health. So it still hasn't quite sunk in yet, I'm not gonna lie. It's obviously, when you've believed something and known something for like 10 years, it's not gonna suddenly go away overnight. And I'm probably gonna have quite an intense therapy session on Thursday, but it is one of the biggest weights off my shoulders that I didn't even know that I needed. I'd got so used to thinking it. Yeah, I just feel like I have quite literally been given the gift of time, and I have been given the ability to have the one thing in life that I really want. And it's like, money can't buy that. Money cannot buy it. Yeah, and obviously it's like crazy, like it brought up a lot of trauma from like the surgery and, you know, everything that I've had to go through to get to this point. Like, it has taken 10 years and it took major surgery, it took major rehabilitation, it has taken major work on myself, but my heart has done it. Honestly, I can't even articulate how incredible it feels to say that. I never thought I would. I, honest to God, thought I'd be in that 50% that it wouldn't do it. So yeah, good times. And yeah, I don't have to freeze any eggs or do any hormone injections, which I was dreading. I don't have to look at any of that unless like I've not met someone in like 5 years time, and then I'm like, okay, probably should do that anyway. But yeah, I've just been given time, and honestly, you can't buy it, it's priceless. So yes, good times. Oh guys, I'm gonna go like proper vlogger style right now. I'm not a vlogger, I'm just documenting my life as we go. I swear to God, the cat moved my remote. Oh, it's there. Can't blame you today. Having a little girly chit chat and just not being on my phone for a few hours and walking about was just what I needed to de-stress. I think it's like 11, 12 dresses because I can't decide what I want to wear in Paris or what I want to wear for my birthday. So I just ordered loads. You know how you can do like pay in 30 days. So I do this all the time when I've got something coming up. I just order loads. And then obviously I send back everything bar one or two. Network settings. I paid for my internet this morning. My very hefty internet bill. That should be working. So rituals is one of my absolute favourites for home things, a few body things. Obviously I get most of my like body products from Avon, but I do love the Rituals exfoliator, and I do use that, but I love it for home stuff. And I love Rituals also because, like Avon, it is a B Corp, so it's really 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 ethical and an amazing brand. So I got, well, to begin with, I got myself a lip balm. I probably didn't need to get this because I've got like a million Arbonne lip balms, but I just loved the packaging and I don't currently have one sat in my car, so I used it as an excuse to buy myself a lip balm. So that was what I got. And then I got, you might be able to see behind me, can you see like there? There's a really big diffuser. Oh no, I think it's kind of blinded. I bought, so the one I've got over there is the cherry blossom one. This one is Karma. I quite liked that it was called the Karma Collection. So it's the blue one. And I just got the small one because basically the one I've got on there, I keep knocking it over and I've probably lost like half the product already. Because it's just too big for where it is. So I've bought this little one to go where that is, and then I'm gonna put the big one in the bathroom where it's never gonna be. Oh, why is the internet not working? Tinterweb is working. Why is the tinterweb not working on the Fire Stick? Lift. Oh, sorry. Lift off. Right. I was watching Clarkson's Farm because everyone was telling me it was really funny. But I'm not going to lie, I didn't really get into it. Is that weird? So yes, I got the little diffuser, which I'm going to put by my bed, and hopefully this one won't fall out. Over. Hey, hunky fit man in the flat, can you come remove this for me? Oh no, it's just me. Don't worry, I can do it myself. Oh, cute, little cutie. I'll put that by the bed in a minute. Oh, pomegranate, pomegranate. You have my heart. It's like little gems, I love it. I also bought an emergency concealer. Charlotte told me to get this one, Maybelline. Give that a go. And I bought a spontaneous lipstick just because I like the color. The lipstick, I don't even know what brand this is. Oh shit, that's quite bright. Ooh. Right, I know you all just want dresses. I did also order some hair product from Look Fantastic. This is something that Lucy swears by. I'm basically shit at doing my hair. I'm just always been, like, always been bad at hair. It's just not my jam. But she used this on me the other day because she does my hair for me when I'm out with her. And I was like, I reckon I could have a go with this. So, what is it? Kevin Murphy bedroom hair. Because I really want to do like a really volumized pony in Paris. And I said to her, I was like, babes, I can't do it. Like, she was like, just buy your own and just have a go with this. So, that is what I'm going to do. Flexible texturizing hairspray. I will do it on camera when I do it and we can have practice. Shit is getting real when the hair goes up. Oh my god, I really hope this looks as nice on as it does off the hanger. That is the ultimate like Hollywood glam red. Oh my goodness, I love this dress. Oh, you can't really see it in that light. Let's move you. Oh god, the camera's gonna die. I absolutely love it. Hot red. So cute. My god, guys. What have I ordered? I look like a freaking strawberry. Oh, it's not even funny. I actually quite like the, like, it's just like plain, like, dress down. But what? I'm sorry, it was not this big on the model. I mean, I guess if I could wear it anywhere, it'd probably be Paris. But, I mean, I look like a strawberry, like properly. Look. Oh, I look like I could like have one of those like flower hats that people wear to like football matches and stuff. No, this is extra as F. But in Paris, imagine, well, push-up bra to start with. In Paris, by the Eiffel Tower, when it's sparkling on the hour, maybe even with like a blazer on, some heels. Oh my god. I am mega excited about this. It obviously looks like not right now, but I think in the right place with the shoes on, the blazer. Oh, it's so sparkly. I need a spray tan. Like, badly, I need a spray tan. But I love it. This is coming to Paris. Oh, taking a big fucking breath. Oh no, why has my hair gone static? We don't do static. I also need to get a move on. So, I'm not putting any makeup on. I've showered, I've washed my hair. No makeup because I am going for my lash and brow appointment. Birthday lashes, birthday brows, woo! Which means there's no point me having makeup because I have a lash lift. So obviously you get all the stickers around here to lift and tint my lashes. And then I'm also having HD brows. So if you don't know what they are, it's basically like a full TLC for your brows. So they shape them. So Linda, who does it, she waxes, threads, plucks. That's it, plucks them, tints them, and then you get like a proper shape, and she does makeup around them actually, so they look really good afterwards. So yeah, I have that done every couple of months. Mine lasts really long, but I'm excited. I've actually had a couple of hours off, so I worked this morning first thing. It's the state of my room. Does anyone else, like, when I get back, my flat was spotless yesterday, and then I got back with like my gym bag, my work bag, like I've had a shower, and it's just a pigsty again. Yeah, what did I do? I worked, and I had a little coffee. I had my therapy session, which was intense. I cried. I never cry. Like, I've never cried in therapy before. I've been doing it 2 years. I've been close. Oh no, maybe once. I have something in me. Like, I've basically been crying nonstop for the last 2.5 days. And it's because everything just feels a bit weird. I need to put some SPF on. So obviously Monday's appointment was amazing, and on like the surface, like, I'm happy. Like, obviously I'm happy. It's incredible what has happened, but underneath the surface, it's almost like, I said to Alicia, the only way I can describe it is like, when I was 15 years old, I was told about my heart, and I almost took this like massive breath in, and I feel like I've been holding on to that breath for the last 10 years, And Monday was like the first opportunity. I feel like I'm getting emotional again. The first opportunity where it was like, right, it's okay. Like, you can let go now. Like, you can let go of that breath. Like, you can breathe again. And it's just the most up and down incredible feeling. Like, it feels amazing, but it also feels scary. Like, you know, it has been such a heavy part of my life that I've almost had to put in a box for so many years just as a coping mechanism, and it's become such a large part of like my identity because I've had it throughout my pivotal growing up, learning, becoming who I am years. And it's like, okay, but who am I without that being part of a big part of who I am? It's a lot. It's heavy shit. Yeah, obviously emotionally, spiritually, physically, I just feel exhausted. I feel like I've been given a lifeline and it's amazing, but my body doesn't perhaps know how to deal with it yet. Like, how do you go from 10 years of being someone and knowing something and having to deal with something to suddenly overnight not having to deal with it? Please just make the time regularly to reflect and to look back and just think to yourself, do you know what? Like, go me. Like, I did that. Like, I did that. I overcame that. I've learned from that. Like, good has come from everything. Like, just embrace that, like, pride for yourself, because honestly, that right now is what is, like, keeping me together. I'm just like, do you know what? No, like, I fucking did it. And I just need my body, like my spirit, I think, and my soul to catch up with where I'm physically at, which is obviously really happy. I'm gonna have my little gut health shot from Marks and Spencer's that I bought the other day. I have done my green shot, my vitamins and stuff, but I saw that, oh my God, I can't speak. I found this in the fridge and I was like, oh, I'm gonna drink that. When they say, like, when these are, like, branded as, like, healthy gut shots, though, be really wary. Don't quote me on this, but I imagine if you actually look at what's in it, it's probably not that healthy. I just love the taste of it. But I did find a recipe the other day for homemade turmeric and ginger and apple shots that you can make in the morning, so I think I might start doing that. But I love this one from Marks, and I think it's because it's got coconut milk in, so it tones down that, like, spicy, it looks like curry paste, it's so funny. Oh, I can't remember when I last vlogged. When did I last pick up the camera? Oh my God, yesterday was such a blur. I was so drained after my therapy session, and I didn't even realize because I had the session and then I had my lashes and stuff. Oh, look at those. Can you even deal with the length on those? I am. They quite literally, look, it curls over. That is how long they are. And I got home and honest to God, I just, my body, you know when you're just like, I'm done. Like, I am done. I think basically I did it. Look at that. It's like the devil whizzer. No messing with this. Fun fact about me, when I had my operation and I couldn't really eat because it made me feel sick, I used to sit on the sofa with a jar of Marmite and a spoon. And I swear to God, I think I got through like one a week. Honestly, it was my weakness when I was ill. I think it was like the comforting, like, salty, so good, it kept me alive. Kept the clip of me drinking that because I had someone say to me on Insta not so long ago, oh yeah, but do you actually drink that or do you just take photos of it? I actually drink it every day. Just got home from my nails. I didn't go French. I went sparkly white basically one of my nails had an acrylic on because it snapped, and it's a different colour to Builder, which is really pink, and it was just going to look weird. So that's what we've got. This is what I cannot stop eating at the moment. Rice with pomegranate and coriander and salmon. And then I've actually got some coleslaw, favourite thing ever. And I have no shame. I'm totally Friday afternoon. I'm in bed, ready to crack out some work. I don't know about anyone else. I am so productive on days like today when I'm just sat in bed. The cat's with me. I put a bit of like Friends on. So much work done. So, yeah, it's work time. And then tonight, I'm going to crack open a bottle of my favourite wine. I've bought some of my favourite chocolate. And it's sex life night, people. It's sex life night. I'm so excited. Oh my God, I can't even explain how excited I am to watch season 2 of Sex Life on Netflix. If you've not watched it, it's the best thing ever. You need to watch it. Oh shit, I don't know. Yeah, no, beet. I think that's chickpeas with tomato. I think there's mash. What is that? I can't remember. Okay, just at Clifton Lido with Lois. Hi. So she's gone four. She was warned that it was a rich dish, but it's squid ink. What is it? Squid ink prawns. No, it's not hake, it's monkfish.
I can't remember.
I think it looks like noodles.
I'm really not sure. Should I have a... The guy was basically trying to...
He was trying to put her off it. It was so funny. He was like, but are you sure you want that? And then I've got hake, which looks delish. I've never been here before. I got so stressed coming here. But this is the Clifton Lido where you've got the pool and a hot tub. And we're just having a little girly Saturday lunch. What do you think? Have you tried it yet?
I haven't. It's very hot and it's steaming.
This is when it's like, yeah, you were right, mate.
I think it's quite nice. Can you try some?
No.
Yeah, try some of it. It's actually quite nice.
Is it alright?
I think it's fine.
So I've send it back.
I don't know what it is though. Maybe it is noodles.
Yeah, this looks really yummy. I might just leave that there.
Oh, I think it's nice. Try some. I'm not like, do you know when you're like, in your first bite and you're like, is it behind something? So I think it is.
Is it noodles?
So, yeah. I think it's noodles, it just has a squid ink. Yeah. You can have some of like the sauce.
Yeah, no, it's not that bad.
Yeah, I think the way that the guy was saying is I expected it to be like...
Yeah, I thought it was gross. Oh my God, I've just got the camera on in time as I'm vlogging. You can see the suspension bridge in the back. Honestly, sometimes I feel so... Oh, JJJ, what does that mean? Sometimes I feel so like lucky, and I just sort of like reminds me like how incredible it is that I live somewhere with such like a famous landmark. But obviously because I've lived here for so many years and I used to go over the bridge every single day for work, and I still do, like quite a lot, you just sort of forget, don't you, like how incredible it is, but it's really not. So I'll stick the vlog camera on as I'm going over it because it's pretty cool. Oh, that's a nice Beamer. Maybe I should look at Beamers. I keep debating getting a new car. Oh my God, my food I've just had was so, so, so good. Oh my God, so yummy. I am well and truly full up. And unfortunately my pudding was not all right. You know, when you just like, I had such a sweet craving after eating something good. But the cream was not good, so I sent it back. And then I didn't want anything else, so I just stopped and got a little hot chocolate. We all know that I'm obsessed with chocolate at the moment. if you live in Bristol, you have to go to Bar Chocolat in Clifton Village. Bar Chocolat in Clifton Village, because they make the best hot chocolate. It's made from like pure melted chocolate. It's so good. And the goat order is milk chocolate, but with coconut milk, and adding on marshmallows and flakes. Oh my god, it's so yummy. It's so good. They also do like loads of different essences and stuff, so you can basically flavor it. So they do like normal ones, like obviously all the vanilla, caramel, everything like that. But then they also do like these essences, so you can get like raspberry, mango, banana, popcorn, mint, like so many. Yeah, I absolutely love them. Apologies, my camera died. I am home. Look at my little cozy setup for a Saturday night. I need to edit the vlog and I need to schedule all my clients' posts for next week, so that I can go away on Monday and not have to worry about work at all. And I'm so excited. So I'm gonna end the vlog. Thank you so much for watching. That was quite a long one actually, so well done if you made it through. I will be back next week, and next week will be live, not live, will be straight from the City of Love, Paris with my bestie, everything we get up to. I'm so excited to film this vlog because obviously it's an amazing place to be, and yeah, we're just gonna have so much fun. So I will see you all next week, straight from Paris.